Hello everyone, Alex here from WornOffKeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can send temporary messages that automatically delete themselves after a certain amount of time. So I have this very basic project here. You can go ahead and clone this from the GitHub repository in the description, or you can code along from scratch. And here we have this very basic starter application. To get started, I'm going to create a new file. This will be called send-message.js. This is going to export a function. The function will take in a channel object, the text, and the duration, and by default, this will be set to 10 seconds. And if we want the text to not disappear, so therefore a permanent message, we would then pass in -1. So what we can do here is we can say channel.send, we can pass the text, and then we can say .then, and we have a message in our callback here. This is after the message is actually sent. We can say if duration is exactly equal to -1, we can return. Otherwise, continuing on, this is saying that duration is not -1. We can then use the set timeout function. And we're going to have an argument here, which is going to be the actual function we're going to run, and then a delay. I'm going to say 1000 times duration. 1000 is how many milliseconds are in a second. So if we pass in 10, it would then be 10 seconds. If we pass in 5, it'll be 5 seconds, etc. So inside of our callback here, because we have access to the message right here, we can simply say message.delete. If we save this, we can open our index.js file. We can then import send message. So constant send message equals require send message. And then we need to get our guild and our channel. So first we're going to get our guild. We can set that equal to client.guilds.cache.git. We have to pass in our guild ID here. To get that, we can go to Discord, we can right-click on our actual server, and click on Copy ID. If you don't see this, then you have to enable developer mode on your Discord account. We can then paste it in here, and this should give us our actual guild. We can then create another constant called channel, and we are going to then want to get our channel here. So I'm going to use this private tutorial channel. We can right-click and copy, just like we did with the guild. We could then say guild.channels.cache.git. Very similar syntax. This is how you typically get things within Discord JS V12. And then we can say send message. And if we look at our parameters, we have channel, the text, and optional duration. The first thing I'm going to test is sending a permanent message. So we can pass in the channel, the text of hello world. And then the third parameter is going to be -1. If we see right here, -1 will ignore the set timeout. So we can save this and we can run our bot with node index.js. It says the client is ready and we see hello world right here. And this actually won't get deleted. However, if I remove this, it'll have a 10 second delay automatically because if you go into send message, the default value is 10. But so we don't have to wait 10 seconds, I'm just going to add in 3. We save this and we restart. We can then go back and we see hello world again. However, this will be deleted in 3 seconds as it just was. And so this is a very useful utility that I typically have in my bots. It's a very simple utility, but it's very useful to be able to actually send a message or send a temporary message, which is often useful to make sure that your channels don't get too cluttered. If you're replying to a user based off of a command, you can use this. And a common use case could be to set the duration by default to be -1. So if you don't specify a time to actually delete the message, then it'll be a permanent message. But if you do specify the duration, let's say 10, then it will actually delete the message in 10 seconds, or whatever you prefer. Thanks for watching this Discord.js tutorial. If you want to learn more about Discord.js, consider clicking on the playlist you see on your screen now. If you need help, feel free to leave a comment or ask in the WornOffKeys Discord, which can be found in the video description.